Where did I get this one? I don't even remember. Good morning and welcome back to my channel. Doing a little bit of a mini vlog today. It's 7:30 in the morning, getting my son off to school, and then my best friend and I are going to spend the day thrifting. Today's her birthday, so what better way to spend your birthday than going thrifting? So we're going to go to a couple Goodwills and a Salvation Army, and I am going to get some footage of our thrifting and a little bit of our day. So I hope you enjoy this video and come thrifting with me. Getting ready to go in here and open up my curtains, but a video that I'm going to be doing up very soon is another hidey hole I have of, I guess it's down here, Valentine's Day things all shoved in there. You probably can't even see that because it's very dark, but that video is going to be coming soon. I mean, I've put out two things, this little banner, and this is El Toro. And actually, Cindy, my best friend who I'm going thrifting with today, she had one of these, and then she found another one and gave it to me. So he is a Hallmark.
My name is El Toro. El Toro of love. And my love for you burns with the heat of 1,000 jalapenos. No, wait. What is El Toro saying? 1,000,000. Yes, 1,000,000 hot jalapenos. Spicy.
Anyway, he's fun. He's from Hallmark, so he always sits out there. But that's the only two things that I have out. So going to be going through that soon. And also this box, I have lots of vintage Valentine's. So this is still that box of cards that I pulled all those Christmas cards out of. They're sitting next to my chair because I really need to sit down and go through. There's Easter cards in there. There's Valentine's Day cards in there. There's birthday cards in there. There's some cool cards in there. I just have to sit down and go through them. So that's going to be upcoming as well. I'm going to try to pull out the Valentine cards and kind of show them when I go through my Valentine stash and hopefully find some more Valentine things today while we're thrifting. Brutus, are you going to be a good boy today? Huh? Are you going to be a good boy? Are you not going to have any potty accidents in the house? Huh? Promise? Okay. You promise. Another thing I wanted to show was this is my sweet Bella girl. This is on canvas, and Emma and Jaden got that for me for Christmas. So it's just kind of a, almost like a life-size picture of our girl. And so we have it hung right here in our entryway. So there's my Bella girl next to my Emma girl. I also wanted to show some sales that I had overnight. I had 3 eBay sales and 1 Mercari sale. So I'll show those to you now. All right, the things that I sold on eBay were these Lucky Brand flats. And this is a single-stitched 1998 Chicago Bulls vintage t-shirt, as well as a single-stitched Elvis I've Been to Graceland t-shirt. This one sold for, I think, $27, and I threw this one in as a bundle, sold it for $10. They will ship through the global shipping program together. And then these, I believe, sold for $19. And then this is a vintage Mickey & Co. sweatshirt from the 90s. Sold for $32 on Mercari. Full asking price. I very rarely get lowball offers for Mercari. I know a lot of people do. I usually don't. And this is good news because I have this exact same sweatshirt in my clothing that needs to be photographed as well in a different color. So that means that I will be able probably to sell that one as well. This sweatshirt on Mercari, I do offer free shipping, and I select the option to provide my own shipping on Mercari. And I go through Pirate Ship, which is a program. It's free to sign up and make an account for. It's wonderful. I use it all of the time. And also all of the things that I use, all these clear poly bags, the poly mailers are all linked below in the description of items that I use in my reselling gig, if you will. Things that I've tried, tested, love, and recommend. But this will go in a padded flat rate mailer. You can order these on USPS.com for free. And it will save you a lot of money in shipping kind of things that are over 16 ounces. These little flats will be able to ship first class in a poly bag, and both of these will fit in a poly bag as well.
Okay, so I just wanted to talk a little bit about, you know, I've been getting a lot of messages and people are saying, oh, I'm so sorry that you're closing the shop. I mean, from local people and from people online as well. And we're thrilled about closing the shop. Honestly, we don't want to be confined to four walls. So if we want to, you know, set up at markets or at an antique mall or kind of maybe even just have an auction and start all over from scratch, that's exciting to me. So that's kind of the plan. We don't quite know what we're going to do yet. We are going to put the building for sale and possibly find, well, we're going to have to find a house that Dad can live with us and have his own space and that we can have room to expand my business a little bit and to possibly even have a little area where we can open up an occasional shop if we want to. So that's kind of what the game plan is. I will be having some sales while I'm at the shop, while I'm kind of going through and cherry picking some of the items that I'm going to keep and sell online. So make sure that you are keeping an eye out for those, because I will be selling things for a really good price, and just wanted to let you know about that. So don't worry about us. We closed because we wanted to, not because we had to. We owned the building outright, so it wasn't a matter of, you know, not being able to afford to have the shop because our overhead was very, very low. We just honestly didn't want to put the time and energy into having to stay there all day on the weekend. So we're kind of getting our life back, and we feel good about that. So it's a good thing, guys. It is a wonderful thing. So just wanted to throw that out there. We have just arrived at our first stop of the day, and that is Goodwill. And there's Cindy. Everybody say happy birthday to Cindy, because today's her birthday. Happy birthday,
thank
Cindy.
You.
But we've just realized something, and this is the way we think. We don't realize these things sometimes until we just pull in to a parking lot, and then we're like, shoot, today's Wednesday, and that's senior discount day. And it's not our favorite day to go because, listen, we are getting to that age where we're going to get that senior discount very, very soon. But it isn't our favorite day to go because people are rude and it's crowded and people are, I don't know. So
it's not comfortable. It's not a good situation.
No. But we're going to go anyway.
We will persevere.
We will. And we're going to find some good stuff to resell or to keep. Never know with us. All right, we're gonna go in.
I mean, you know, the music is extremely loud, so I don't know how much of this.
It's a cute
dog.
Yeah. Aww. Cute.
He's so cute.
Bank.
He is pretty cute. Look at his little snaggle tooth. He is cute.
He is cute.
Look at his little snaggle tooth right there. Oh, Cindy, look. That is super cute. It kind of looks like, I know, I seems like it looks like it, but I don't know. I think it might be. It's not marked. I know, and it's not a shaker. She's kind of had it. She is over the Goodwill shelf.
Oh, Cindy, there's a blue bow duck.
Yes.
Up there. First one of the day. Starbucks coffee. This is a made in Japan one for $1. I need another mug, like I need a hole in my head. Oh, those are
ducky.
Chicken swans? Hey, here's a Homer Simpson pizza cutter. It must make...
It's like a little pizza.
It says it makes some sort of noise. It's 50 cents. Going into one more Goodwill. It's not been that great, but I'm going to try to get some footage in here. The music is just so loud that it makes it really hard to get any footage. So we'll see if I can in here. Does he say who he is?
I can't see anything.
He's
middle-aged man.
He's got a watch on.
He's looking for me. For love.
Oh, he's looking gosh. For love. No, he's not. No, he's not. Okay. What else?
Stop playing music.
What's this, girl?
I think that's the song from
the Incredible. I don't know. There's just not a lot going on here so far. What is that? It's still playing. It's never going to end. She's got no shoes.
She's from 1996. She's never had shoes.
She's Ashton Drake. Someone probably paid $50 for her at one time. Look.
Oh. He really wants to push the cart, but he can't reach.
Pony for Christmas. It's a magical.
Oh, it is magical.
All I can see is her little, her feet. Okay, we're missing something. Something has to be good here. I mean, there's projects down here. I mean, there's a snow baby. I don't know. There's a project there. And she is over it, too. Sure, we're just not seeing a lot of stuff today. We've kind of been kind of striking out. It's not been a good day. So this is the next day, and I hate that I didn't get a lot of footage while we were inside the thrift stores, but honestly the music was so loud, it was just really loud, and I didn't have really good chance to film. But I just got a little bits and pieces just so you can see. That's kind of rough when you're trying to film and the music is blaring. And if you don't know, then we can't play a lot of music on our channels because then we'll get a copyright strike and then they'll take our video down. So we have to kind of juggle the music and non-music. And I know a lot of people will do kind of voiceovers. That's just, I don't like to do that because I want you to authentically see me when I'm finding things. So I don't really want to do the voiceovers. So that's why. Okay, so let me go ahead and tell you, I spent $30 on everything that I'm going to show you, which is probably a record for me because normally when I go out, I spend way more than $30 because, you know, I was buying differently. I was buying more to kind of put things in the shop. And now I'm kind of buying things differently. Well, I am buying things differently to sell things online. So let me go ahead and show you what I found. I'll go ahead and get the two clothing pieces out of the way. And honestly, I'm not really buying a lot of clothing pieces unless it's something that I've sold before that I know that I can make a profit on, or if it's something that's really cool and vintage and unique. This is a shirt that I paid $1.99 for at one of the Goodwills that we went to. It's a Tommy Bahama Relax. It's a 2X. It's got the little pocket tee with the stitching. I got this for my husband. He likes it. So this is for him. But I thought if he didn't like it, then I can list it and resell it. So that's for him. The other thing I got were these kind of a pale pink fit flops. I do well with these. Shoes were $4.50, and I could probably sell these for about $20-$25 or so. So I got those, and they are a size 7, I believe. I don't know. I kind of wishing that I wouldn't have bought those, but I did. So I'll try to resell them. All right, and I also picked up from Goodwill this big lantern. The candles inside. It has the battery operated candles. You know, I haven't even tested this to see if the bonus. It does work. I didn't even test it to see if it did. I'm actually going to put this on my porch. So I don't really care if it works because I probably won't even turn it on most of the time. But this was on the cart that they wheeled out. You know, you hear that
If you're a thrifter, you hear the cart being rolled out and you make a dart for the cart and everybody else's too. But this was $4.99, which is a really good price because these are really expensive to buy in the store. So this is something that will go on my front porch. Okay. I'm still sticking with that same Goodwill. I also bought... Now, I am doing a little bit of a Valentine's Day collaboration with some other YouTube channels, so I'm not going to really go into details for it, but I do want to show some of the things that I've got to use for that collaboration. And the two of these bowls, they are Isaac Mizrahi. So they're not old, but they are thrifted, and that's part of the challenge. So I got two of these bowls, and this is for a collaboration that I will be doing very soon. And I also got these two red plates. These are, I can never say this, Wackerbach, Germany. I have sold these mugs before, so I know that there are a collector's market for these. Because I'm probably, after this collaboration is over, I'm going to sell these because I don't need them. But I got them for the collaboration. But they were $1.99 each. And how much were these bowls? These bowls were 99 cents. Each. So red was the color of the week and I didn't get anything that was half price. So I also picked up these. Now these are vintage. I haven't taken them out of the box to really look them over to see if they're marked anything. Let me just show you what they are. I paid $1.99 for them and they are just these silver napkin rings. They are in their original box, but let's see if they're marked with any maker's mark on them. And I'm not seeing that they are. I mean, they're not sterling. They're just kind of a brushed silver. But let's see if there's any name anywhere. There's not. There's no name on them. There was a tag here. So they're probably from the 70s, 80s, but I needed them for my little project I'm going to be doing. So I got those. All right, from also that same Goodwill, and I don't know, this resembles Holt Howard to me, and I haven't researched it, so I don't quite know if it is, but look at this little kitty cat. Do I need this in my life? Well, I kind of need it in my life because I like this kind of things. Do I want it in my life? That's the difference. I don't need it in my life, but look at him. Doesn't he resembles a Holt Howard, and he was 99 cents. So I had to get him. There isn't any maker's mark on him anywhere. You know, if he had his original sticker, it's long gone. But he is in great condition, and I just love his little face. So I'm keeping him. And his little long neck with his bow. I think he'll actually look kind of cute in my Valentine's decor because he's got that little pink bow. So he's like a little lovey cat. So we'll put him in the Valentine's Day decor. And also at that one Goodwill, I picked up another Mary's Angels. Now, I collect these, and I don't think that I have this one, although, well, and it was 99 cents. Now, I did just sell one for about $25, but it was in the box. So, I'll have to look up the date. I want to say this kind of looks like Sweet William, but I don't know. It's dated 1999, I think. It's so hard to see. I need to get a loop, but... he needs cleaned up. He's very dirty. But I do like these little Mary's Angels. And they're all named after flowers. They're made by Hallmark. Okay. And I also picked up this for a friend. When she sees it, she'll know who she is. It's made by World Market. So it's not vintage. But it's a little spoon rest. And it was also 99 cents. So you know who you are. This is coming your way. So I got that for her, and I believe that's all I got at that Goodwill. So then after that Goodwill, we went to Salvation Army, and I bought nothing. And let me just tell you, Cindy and I were having this conversation in the car, how we thought Salvation Army is so nice because the prices are so much cheaper. No, that's not the case anymore. They've raised their prices in our Salvation Army. We saw a couple of glasses from the 1980s, the Alvin and the Chipmunk glasses, you know, the collectible glasses, they wanted $6 a piece for them. So somebody is looking up prices on eBay and pricing them eBay prices, which is ridiculous for a Salvation Army. So stop doing that, Salvation Army, because no one's going to buy them. So they're going to sit there on your shelf because nobody's going to buy them. And I don't think that, maybe does Salvation Army have like an equivalent to the bins that they send things to? I don't know, but we didn't buy anything in there because everything was overpriced. So then after the first Goodwill we went to a little thrift store that we have only been in once before. And when we went in there, we thought, we don't really like this thrift store. But we went back again, and then we thought, we really kind of like this little thrift store. It's called Opportunity House. And so it's just like a little charitable thrift store, kind of out in the middle of nowhere. I did get some, I bought three things in there. The first thing, and I'm really bummed because I have to go buy batteries for it, but I don't know why I bought it. It was 50 cents, and it's this Homer Simpson pizza cutter. But when it needs batteries, and I have to replace the batteries. But when you cut into your pizza, Homer speaks. So that's fun. I don't know what he says, but he was 50 cents, and I thought, this is going to be fun. When we have pizza, we can have Homer Simpson talk to us. I don't know. It was 50 cents. The next thing I got also is going to go with the collaboration video that I'm going to do are these. I got a set of four napkins, cloth napkins. And I have been saying that I've been wanting to pick up cloth napkins of different colors for different holidays. And so these I can use for Valentine's Day. I can also use them for Christmas. I could also use them for the 4th of July if I wanted to. So these were 10 cents a piece. So I got those to go with the video that I'm going to be doing. And this thing was, well, it's one of the best things that I got yesterday. I'm really excited about it, especially for what I paid for it. And it is this great little hot air balloon. And I don't know exactly the name. Maybe it's just called hot air balloon. I don't know. I'm not versed on Pyrex names for the most part. But this one is a more rare print. And I paid $1.80 for it. Now, when I was paying for it, the lady at the checkout said, wow, who priced this at $1.80? And I was like, I don't know, but I'm glad they did. So it's in great condition. It is Pyrex. It is the, was it 1.5 pint bowl? You can see there it is, Pyrex. It's the number 32. I did look up comps for these, and this one sells for about $34 in this size. Now, this is what's considered Cinderella Bowl, so this is one of five or six that's stacking together. This is probably the smallest of the set, and it's a rare design. It's in great condition. It does have a little bit of, you know, wear around the rim of the little lips that it sits in, or that it rests on, but this was a great find for $1.80. So, and I'm not sure, but it looks like they just set this out, because I think that 1-8 is the date, and she said that they were just setting out a bunch of new donations, so we stuck around for as long as we could, but they weren't moving us very fast, and so we had to move up on our way, but definitely a place that we're going to check out again. All right, and then we also went to another little thrift store, and I didn't buy anything in there, but as we were leaving, they had some Christmas things free. So I did grab these. They were free, and I do believe that these are girly candles, and they had them marked for $1, and I would have gladly paid $1 for them, but since they were free, they're going to be free for me. And they don't have, sorry about the paper, I should have taken these out before I started filming this video. They no longer have the little paper labels on the bottom, but I do believe that these are girly candles. And they, I thought maybe one was a boy and one was a girl, but I think that they're both the girls because of their little hair cuts. So these I'm going to be keeping as well. So they're pretty cute. So those were free, so that's a great, I like free. Free's a great price. And then we went to another Goodwill, and I only got three things at this other Goodwill. We went to three Goodwills altogether, and I'm going to save the kind of hopefully the most profitable thing for the last part. But I did pick up this, and I don't know, I debated on not getting this because I have yet to really go through my inventory at the shop. I'm still trying to figure out what we're going to do, how we're going to liquidate, and I'm going to obviously cherry pick things that I'm going to either keep or that I'm going to sell online. So I probably have lots of these because this is something that I know that Dad has bought, and it's something that I'm kind of getting you into now. And it's just this little tiered tray. It's not sterling, it's just metal. It's just probably silver plate. I like the patina on it, so I thought it would look neat as sort of like a tiered tray for different tchotchkes that I'm going to put on it. I debated on getting it because I probably have like five of these at the shop that are just been sitting around, and I don't know that I have because we have so much stuff there. There isn't any maker's mark on it, but I did pay $3.99 for it, which kind of made me debate, but I just thought, oh, I'm just going to get it. So I might use this in that collaboration video that I'm going to be doing too, but you know, I will use it to put different little tchotchkes on in a display in my home. So I did get that. And then these two little guys were very surprising to me. I think that they're adorable. I like this kind of folk art, primitive looking Halloween decor. And here is the little witch. And look at her little face. And she's sweet. She's holding a little jack-o'-lantern. And on her little base, it says, "My mom says I'm pretty." But she's got like these little, you know, she's like little dancing. Little springs that are making her dance. She is made, she was 99 cents. She was made by August Moon. I'm gonna peel the sticker off, which again, peel your stickers off as soon as you can, because the longer they sit on your item, the more you're gonna be mad that you didn't peel them off sooner, because they're gonna be harder to get off. But this is made by August Moon by Lang. And it's called The Little Witch. And I looked up comps for these. I didn't look them up in the store because I thought, even if she's not worth anything, I like her and I'm going to keep her. But she's worth like, she's been selling for like $25. So I can turn this 99 cents into about $25 plus shipping. So I'm probably going to sell her. I don't know. She's cleaned up a little bit. She's a little dusty. Then sitting right next to her was her little pumpkin man friend, the little pumpkin patch boy. Look at his little hands. Is it gonna focus? See his little hands? Isn't he cute? His little broom, 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 broom. He sells for about $20 as well. And he was also 99 cents. And he's also made by August Moon. Let me scrape off his tag so you can see. The nice thing about these, he's the Pumpkin Patch Boy. See here, August Moon. Is that gonna focus? Kind of. Ooh, there we go. They're made in China, but they are collectible. They were made by Lang, which Lang, you know, is a, they make little novelties and things like that. But so I don't know. I might try to sell these as a set together. But aren't they cute? So I picked those up. So sometimes little things like that you think, you know, you may sit and think, oh, they're mass produced, they're not going to be worth anything. Still look them up, because sometimes these things they're not as mass produced as you may think that they are. Okay. And so the last thing is kind of could be the biggest moneymaker thing that I bought, but it's also the kind of the questionable thing. And I picked this up the last stop of the day. We went to our little local Goodwill here in Bedford. And I go there a lot, so I wasn't expecting to find much. But I'm looking for a frame. I have a vintage Mackinac Island, which if you know me, you know Mackinac Island is like, I love that place. It's my favorite place in the whole wide world, and I collect Mackinac Island things. And I have an old felt pennant that I was looking for a frame for to repurpose. So I found this frame, just, you know, a long frame. And it had this print, which isn't my style. It's like a house, a really tall house or a castle that I noticed on the bottom. First of all, it was just set so nicely in this frame. It was professionally framed. And then I noticed that it had a number and a signature on the bottom. And it's Bob Holloway. And this is number 332 out of 350. Now, here's the thing that I'm questioning. It has this kind of, what is this called? This paperwork on the back that somebody has paperclip to it. And it says that this is an offset lithography reproduction from an original pen and ink oil by Bob Price Holloway. Each print is signed and numbered by Bob Holloway to authenticate the work. So I looked these up, and one similar to this sold for $180. The thing that I'm trying to figure out is, was that one, because it didn't really say, was that one also a offset lithography reproduction? So I have to research this a little bit. But even so, other ones that I was seeing that wasn't this exact same one, sorry about the glare, were selling for about $80. So I thought for $3.99, it was definitely worth the risk. And if anything, if it's not worth anything, I'm going to use the frame to put my pennant in. So I need to do a little bit more research on this to find out, was it the original that was worth $180? I don't know, but there's potential here. So that was an exciting find. And after I found this one, Cindy and I went back and looked, and we looked to see if there were any more, and there wasn't. But so look at artwork. This is not my style. Like, I would not have this in my home, although I would repurpose the frame if it's worth nothing. So I do have some use for it. But if you can see that something is quality, take the time to sit there and take 5 minutes to look up some comps on it and see if it's worth the $4 investment that you're going to put into it. So that's my tip of advice. Just take the time to look something up if it feels like it might be a quality piece. Usually there's money in there. Someone just took that off their wall, and they probably paid a lot of money for that because it's professionally framed, and they just were sick of it and they decided to donate it. I mean, we've done that. I've done that. Haven't you done that? Haven't you just looked around and thought, I'm so sick of looking at that thing. I don't care how much I paid for it 10 years ago. I'm tired of it, and I'm going to donate it because I just want to be rid of it. That's the beauty about thrift stores, because they're so convenient for us just to kind of get rid of our stuff. But there are treasures to be had for us that scavenge these things. So that's my tip of advice. Look for these things. Just because they're in the thrift store doesn't mean that they're not. It could be, you know, worth $180. And I don't want to ship that, but I will for $180. Anyway, that's the haul. Sorry that I haven't been posting a lot this week. I have a kind of a delay in one of my sponsored videos, so I'm working through that. So my What Sold video will be later than what it normally is, but it is coming, so have no fear. You can see how horrible my sales were last week, because they weren't very good. Anyway, I hope that you enjoyed this little vlog and shop with me and haul, and I'm going to continue to do this sort of video. If you like it, I'd hope that you give it a thumbs up. Make sure that you leave a comment. Commenting in people's videos, even if you just put a little heart or a little smiley face, or a little thanks for sharing, it really does help our channels get boosted up in the search rankings for YouTube. So put a little comment, say hi. It doesn't take that much time. And give it a thumbs up, and I will see you guys in my next video.